Research, my friends, is the foundation for everything we do here at West Virginia University. From nanotechnology to cosmology, from video games that help stroke patients to coal byproducts that power technology. The research conducted by our talented faculty and students reflects back on our land grant mission to help enrich the lives of the people of this state, this country, and the world. In this email, we will take a look at some of the research that is happening on our campus. So, let's go.
We do applied poultry research. So mm-hmm. we do a lot with feed manufacture and looking at various feed additives mm-hmm. and some antibiotic alternatives mm-hmm. and a lot of enzymes that can help make birds more efficient.
Through this research, we're really improving the quality of poultry and the ability for us to be competitive in the wider world, right?
Yeah, absolutely. The mill makes about a ton an hour.
2 million chicks a day, a ton in an hour. This is big time stuff. So here's the question. Why do you cross the road? That's what I thought, you don't know. Okay, so I press it down and then pull it up, right?
Press, yeah, inside, yeah.
In this lab, we are doing a variety of different types of applied forensic chemistry. We're doing a lot of work with the novel synthetic substances, some of the fentanyls and opioids we've been hearing so much about. Some of the opioid crisis is related to what happens in the lab.
The laboratory helps us to understand how we can solve it.
Exactly, and we help people that are in the front lines working every day.
I'm interested in studying synthetic cannabinoids, identifying the metabolites of those synthetic cannabinoids.
What does that mean?
The gold standard really is DNA, because we can provide an actual statistical number, but a lot of the other techniques we can't.
What you're doing is making it so that we can find people through other kinds of chemical processes, so to speak,
yeah.
And therefore we don't have to totally rely on DNA. Boy, did I do a good job?
Yes, you did.
Did I get an A plus?
Yes.
We love forensic science, right?
So here at the Rockefeller Neuroscience Institute, we're bringing people from all over the country to help advance the neuroscience applications for chronic pain, opioid addictions, Alzheimer's, and human performance to improve military and athletic performance and recovery.
A lot of the athletics teams use this, right, to monitor heart rate and respiration, skin temperature, and so forth.
When I have that little thing that you've given to me, that little thing I stick on my finger,
yes.
and I read my heart rate, that is an important component of who I am, right?
Yes, absolutely. 30 seconds can tell you a lot about your physical well-being, your balance, different parts of your body. This is
technology that allows us to really combat the opioid crisis.
I want them to develop a relationship with a virtual therapist that's on their phone.
Oh, wait a second. So this is part of opioid recovery?
It is, mm-hmm. Yes.
That is amazing. In 2016, it was such a joy to see West Virginia University earn its classification as an R1 research university. What that means is that we are on par with institutions like Yale and Johns Hopkins for having the highest research activity. And they are on par with us. You just saw a few examples of why we are the cream of the crop. Neil Armstrong once said, "Research is creating new knowledge." And that is what mountaineers do, create new knowledge to make the world a better place.